There is a huge difference between the nutritional quality of eggs that your chickens lay for you in your own backyard and the kinds of eggs you can buy at the grocery store. Here I have two different plates of scrambled eggs, one made from eggs that my own flock have laid for me and one made from supermarket eggs. And they look quite different, they behave differently when you're cooking with them, and most importantly, they have a very different nutritional profile. Today we're going to dive into how you can increase the nutritional density of the eggs that your chickens lay in your own backyard and why that matters so much. There can be major nutritional differences in different eggs depending on the lifestyle of the chickens who laid them. So for the eggs I bought to do this demonstration with, they are barn eggs. I bought them from the grocery store. They are from chickens who are kept indoors all the time in great big chicken sheds just eating a commercial bagged feed diet. And that gives us this plate of scrambled eggs with this kind of unappetizing color going on with it. And of course, I also used eggs from my own flock. These are chickens who get to free range constantly and have a huge amount of variety, plant and animal food in their diet. And that gives us this rather vibrant colored plate of scrambled eggs here. Now, just to be clear, I cooked these exactly the same. They're just two eggs cooked in a pan with absolutely nothing else, including it was the same pan. So that is what it is. Now, they can get a little bit tricky when they're selling supermarket grocery store eggs. So here I have eggs that I have cracked, and this is one of my eggs and one of the supermarket eggs. And at face value, their yolk colors are not massively dissimilar. This one here is the one from the supermarket, and it actually could be considered to be a little brighter than my egg, but the color tone is a little different, and this is my egg here on the right. So that's my right, that would be your left. Now, they look kind of the same when you're looking at them like that, but this egg is colored from additives that they put into the chicken's diet. And this egg, the egg from my flock, is colored by the grass and the silver beet and all the plants and bugs that my chickens are foraging for. So it is a much more natural color, and that color comes through in the cooking where it stays that bright color. Whereas once you start cooking the supermarket egg, you're getting this very sort of pale peachy color rather than a vibrant yellow that you're looking for. That indicates that there are good things inside that egg. In my experience, there are also some major structural differences in the quality of the eggs between really, really healthy chickens that are laying them and chickens kept in an industrial system. So here with these eggs, and unfortunately, it's really hard to see these differences on camera, so I suggest you do these tests for yourself. But I find that the egg white is much weaker from a supermarket egg, and the actual quality of the yolk, the strength of it, how it whisks up, how it holds together is very different. You'll be able to see that there is a major height difference between the egg from my flock and the egg from the supermarket, where the egg from the supermarket is sitting really flat and the egg from my flock is sitting up and perched in the egg white. And I do find that the egg whites from my own flock, they hold together. So I can crack an egg into a pan and the white will stay around the yolk. It doesn't just dribble away weakly. And all of those differences tell us something about what is actually in the egg. And what is in the egg is nutrition for us when we eat it. So we're looking for the highest quality nutrition from the eggs that we are eating, because that's ultimately going to be better for our health. Nutritional density is not just about the precise diet that an animal or a plant for that matter has. It's about the entire system that supports that animal in its daily life. So from that perspective, we're going to dive in to look at exactly what the differences are between eggs from animals, from chickens that have access to foraging and pasture, and eggs from chickens that are kept in a commercial industrialized system. eggs from pasture-raised chickens have a much higher level of omega-3 in them. And that omega-3 exists in a much better ratio with omega-6 than in commercial eggs. And of course, we are wanting more omega-3s in our diet rather than more omega-6s. So from that perspective, pasture-raised eggs are a much better choice. Pasture-raised eggs have 38% higher levels of vitamin A, which means that you can get 20% of your daily requirement from just two eggs versus only 8% if those eggs are from commercial chickens. Pasture-raised eggs also have 3 times more vitamin D because chickens that are running around in the sunshine can make more vitamin D in their system, and vitamin D is essential, and lots of us don't get enough of it in our diet or we don't spend enough time outside in the sun. Vitamin E levels are up to 4 times more in pasture-raised eggs, and beta carotene, so that is what makes the yolks their beautiful yellow color. It's 7 times or more higher in pasture-raised eggs, and that is quite important because the carotenoids in the eggs, so that is things like lutein and zeaxanthin, things that are antioxidants for us when we eat them, they're really important. They are much, much higher in eggs from chickens, so we're able to go around choosing what plants to eat and having access to green leafy plants in the first place. Minerals like calcium, copper, and selenium are also higher in eggs from chickens who have a more natural diet. And that brings us to protein. Now, eggs are a great source of protein, whether they're from the supermarket or whether they are from eggs from your own backyard flock. They are a great source of protein. But when your chickens have an excellent diet, they're going to have even more protein. They're going to have a better balance of essential amino acids. Now, all eggs contain all 9 essential amino acids, but the ratios in which they occur can be different depending on the diet that the chicken is eating. So if you make sure that your flock has absolutely everything that they need to be healthy, then the eggs that they lay for you are going to be that much better. So why does the system that chickens are kept in matter so much? What is creating all of these nutritional differences? Well, when your chickens are able to access a high quality area to forage with great soil biology growing excellent quality plants, then they are able to get into their diet what they need to be healthy. So when they're cruising around eating grass, legumes, all the different things that they find, green leafy vegetables, whether that's ones that they're finding or that you're providing to them, when they're in the sunshine, when they're in the fresh air, when they're able to look and hunt for bugs and insects and all the little creepy crawlies that they like to put into their diet, they are getting all of the things that their body needs. They're getting the ability to synthesize vitamin D from their sun exposure. They're getting a complete range of amino acids from the different plants that they're eating, and they're getting essential fatty acids from the bugs that they're eating. So they're absolutely being able to compound all of that high quality nutrition that they are getting in their diets into their eggs, and they can pass that nutritional density onto us when we eat those eggs. So what can you do to ensure that you're providing absolutely everything that your flock needs to lay you super nutritionally dense eggs? Well, it's a bit of a sliding scale, but it is important to remember that a lot of this is about what your chickens are eating. Well, most of it is about what your chickens are eating. So if all your chickens are getting is bagged feed from the feed store and they are kept in a run and don't have any access to fresh forage, or you're not bringing them any fresh foods, then your egg quality is going to be somewhat similar to the commercial eggs that you can buy in the supermarket. It won't be quite that bad. But when your chickens have limited options and they're eating a heavily grain-based diet, where that is pretty much like 90% of what they're eating is coming from grains, well, you're not going to get like that great omega-3 increase from a heavily grain-based diet, things like that. So what can you do? Well, Ideally, in a perfect world, your chickens would be able to come out for at least a couple of hours a day and be able to forage on diverse species of plants in an area that has insects and all sorts of things going on. But I do know that that is not possible for everyone, and we do not want to make this something that's impossible to achieve. So there are lots of strategies that you can work in to get your chickens the diet that they need whilst not letting them destroy your entire backyard. The first thing you can do if it's not possible to let your chickens out to forage is to bring them fresh food. So that means you might have to buy it, but ideally you can grow it. It's really easy to grow green leafy vegetables for your chickens. That's things like Swiss chard, kale, spinach, all the different brassicas. You can give them radish greens. You eat the radishes for yourself, feed them the greens. All those little things will help. Bringing them pasture grasses, just cutting some stuff off your lawn and taking it to your chickens will absolutely help. When you mow your lawn, giving the grass clippings to your chickens in their run will provide them with an opportunity to forage through it and find things that they want to eat. You can absolutely grow these things really cheaply and easily. Leafy greens are like the easiest thing to grow, and they pretty much grow all year round. Another thing that you can do if you have a lawn is when you mow your lawn, you can preserve the grass as a silage. And I have a video about that where I talk about making it in vacuum seal bags. So you can preserve the abundance of grass that occurs in the springtime and the autumn time for feeding to your chickens in the winter or the summer when there is less fresh feed available to them. A great strategy that requires just a little bit of organization is making pots or grow bags that you plant your vegetables, your leafy green vegetables and grasses and legumes into, and grow them for your chickens. And then you take the whole pot or bag into the chicken run, let the chickens graze it down and scratch through it, and then take it out and top it up with potting soil, put more seeds in and let the plants come away again and keep doing that. Now, depending on how many chickens you have, that might be a good idea or it might just be an impossible idea. But if you only have a handful of chickens, then having about 5 grow bags that you can rotate in and out is a great way to give them living food, because they're still growing when you give it to them. So that is a great strategy, which I would highly recommend you getting started on if you are unable to let your chickens out of their run to go and forage around in the wider world. If you are able to let your flock out to free range, there are things you can do to improve the environment where they are ranging. So if you have an area that doesn't have a lot of plant species diversity, you can work on making the diversity of plants way better by planting more. You can add different species into your lawn, which can be as simple as just throwing out different seeds into your lawn and letting them grow among the grasses. So you can add in clovers, you can add in different legumes, you can add in plantains and different species of grass. Your lawn might not look quite as uniform and tidy, but it's going to provide a much better diet for your chickens. You can plant different trees and shrubs and bushes that provide different environments, not necessarily for your chickens to eat, but they might create zones for different insects to hang out and for different things to be happening in the soil, which all benefits your chickens' diet in the long run. So really working on improving the diversity of species in the area that your chickens have access to is going to dramatically improve the nutrition available to them. It is important to note that if you have quite a few chickens and not a large space for them to free range in, that they can actually decrease the plant diversity if they are overstocked in an area for too long. So if that's the case, you might be better to restrict their free range and rotate it around different areas so that the chickens are not overgrazing an area and actually reducing the amount of nutrition available to them. Usually chickens will absolutely improve the soil where they are and increase the diversity of the plant life, but you can't let them stay in any area for too long if there are too many any of them for that space. So do keep that in mind. There is a bit of management involved in here, but it will absolutely reap great rewards if you stay on top of it. Some breeds of chickens are better at foraging than others, and some individuals within all breeds are better at foraging than others. Chickens learn from other chickens, so you can develop a culture of excellent foraging in your flock by making sure you have individuals that can teach the others. This is particularly noticeable in the difference between chicks that are raised with a hen and chicks that have been raised artificially. Chicks raised by broody hens are always excellent foragers. I have seen chickens who don't recognize earthworms as food, but every single chick I've ever had that's been raised by a broody hen gets on in there and grabs the worm. So there is definitely learning that happens in terms of chickens' ability to understand and be good at foraging. And you can develop a good foraging culture in your flock by making sure you find some individuals that can teach the others. Chickens have deep wisdom about what their nutritional needs are. The more choices they can make for themselves to select from plants and insects in healthy, diverse environments, the healthier they and their eggs will be.